Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Zamrud Zainal. Okay, thanks for watching my videos. And today I will continue on this well test validation. Based on the previous video, I already shown you on how to validate a well test data, which is a good data. If it is a good data, the procedure that you need to follow in Prosper is just it's summarized here. First, you have to estimate the U values, and then you do the correlation comparison. In these steps, you will QC the well test data, whether it falls within the minimum and maximum limit or not. If it is outside of this max, higher than max or lower than mean, the minimum, then the data is invalid, or maybe your model is invalid. If it is if the data also match with the pre-selected VLP correlation, in this case you already it matches with your petroleum expert 5 PE5, then basically your VLP portion of the model is correct. There is no need for you to do the matching. You can skip the steps to the final step, which is the final which is the VLP and IPR analysis. Okay, in the final steps, VLP IPR, this is where basically you will run both VLP and IPR calculations to see whether the data match with IPR, because in steps 2 you already QC your VLP component of the of these calculations. So if the IPR component is matched, that means it's your data is in good conditions. If you reach that conclusion, then the analysis is complete. Okay, and different scenario which I will show you in this video, we will do the VLP we'll do the well test validation, but in this case the VLP is not good, it's bad. Okay, similarly we start with the step 1, estimate your values, and then step 2 we do the correlation comparison. Okay, this is where we identify that the data deviates, well test data is deviate from the calculated values from this correlation that you already choose. Before you can proceed to the final analysis, you have no choice but to validate the VLP. Validate VLP meaning you will tune the correlation in order to get the correlation to match with the test data. Once you did that, then you can proceed with the VLP and IPR calculation, the final steps. Then if after that we will discover that the test is good, then the analysis will stop. Okay, what happened if the scenario is the VLP data is good but the IPR data is bad? Or at the same time, the VLP can be bad data, bad, it's not matched, and the IPR also you cannot match. So this is what we will do. As usual, we start with the step 1, estimate U value. Then we make a correlation comparison. So this is where basically we realize that our VLP is bad, does not match with the test data. If it's good, then you can proceed to the VLP IPR. If it's not, then you have to do the matching first, match VLP. Once you match the VLP, then you can proceed to VLP IPR. So basically this is where you realize that your IPR data, your test data that does not match with the IPR VLP. So this is where you have to, since you already corrected the VLP portions under using a match VLP, now you have to correct your IPR. Then you have to proceed to the adjust IPR function in Prosper. So this is where either you change the productivity index or skin data depending on the type of reservoir model that you use on the IPR sections. Once you did that, then your intersections, the VLP and VLTR intersection will eventually match with the test data. If it happens, then you have to repeat the final the analysis on VLP and IPR, and to see whether if the error is acceptable. If yes, then the analysis is complete. Okay, let's proceed with the analysis. Okay, this is the test data. I will select test data 3 and 4 together. Okay, I just select the range, copy, go to Prosper model, go to the VLP imaging, select here and paste. I will disable the data. I will start with test 3, so I will disable test 4 first. Okay, estimate the value. I will do the correction comparison. Again, I will use Dun & Rose and Function & Brown. At the same time, I will stick to PE5 because PE5 was proven to be suitable for this model. It's not a it is a good practice to stick to the same correlation throughout the field life. You are not supposed to jump from one correlation to another if you have a different real test of data. Okay, so let's do the calculations. Make the comparison. I remove the temperature. Here you can see that the data is deviates from Petroleum Expert. And what happened if I don't make any correction? If I just ignore this deviation? So if I just proceed to the VLP IPR for test data 3, remove this one. As you can see here, it will be a big error. The difference in liquid rate is high, the difference in the bottom hole pressure is high. That's why I need to go back and do the matching. So select test 3, I have to do the matching. I have to match my PE5 correlation. So that's the matching parameters. Done. Okay, again I go back to this VLP IPR, the final steps, remember? Here you can see your Petroleum Expert 5. There is the tuning parameter at the back of the PE5. Then I make sure I select the proper test data, and then do the calculations. Okay, as you can see here, VLP IPR is now matched and the error has been corrected. Okay, since I'm changing these parameters, so what I will do is I will record that number in my Excel. Parameter 1, parameter 2. So for test data, parameter 1 and so this I just want to make sure that I can keep track on the tuning factors. Okay, so I save it. So basically I'm done with the test data number 3. Okay, so basically that's how we more or less tune the parameters. Okay, Thank you very much. And don't forget to subscribe my channels. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.